Hello, buddy. Today I'm gonna be trying something a little bit different. I am going to be reading a Dead by Daylight fanfic story called The Entity's Realm. And I like fanfic stories, mainly like the horrifying and action ones. The romantic ones, I'm not really a fan of. So, anyways, let me know what you think of this and if I should finish the rest of this story because I'm pretty sure the story is complete by the time I'm recording this. So, anyways, hope you enjoyed. The Entity's Realm, written by Finister Yal, Chapter 1. No, you don't understand, a voice sighs. I can't go with you on Halloween. I have to watch my sister. We can't leave the house. But Death, the voice on the phone whined. Death was currently on the phone talking to their friend Harrison about Halloween. Can I at least come over and we can watch scary movies? Harrison asked. He always was a sucker for horror. Death didn't like them, but if Harrison was there, it was fine. All right, but only after I put Jules to bed. Julie, oh, I have to insert a last name here. Julie Bean, Death's babysitter. All right. Death could practically feel Harrison's grin. See you tomorrow then. Bye, Harrison. Bye. He hangs up. Death sighs and sets the phone on the nightstand before falling backwards onto the bed. Tomorrow was Halloween. They weren't very excited though. Halloween in, into the town name. Halloween in Blaho was usually boring because it was such a small town. Thinking about the next day, they fall asleep, not noticing the spider-like arms surrounding them. A loud blood-curdling scream jolts me awake. Looking at my surroundings, I notice I'm in a strange forest. Thick fog lingers close to the ground, making it hard to see anything but the closest trees from where I was sitting. I stand up and freeze in horror. About 20 feet away from me, in clear sight, is a girl with red hair in a tracksuit hanging from a large meat hook. She is staring straight at me. I run over to her. Oh my god, are you okay? I ask quickly. She nods in response. Help me off of here, she grunts. I nod and reach up, lifting her up off the hook. A chainsaw sounded in the distance. Shit, hurry, he's coming! She exclaims and grabs my hand, running. I stumble slightly, but follow as we hide behind a large rock. Here, wrap this around my shoulder. She hands me a roll of gauze. I nod and start wrapping it around her shoulder, surprised at how calm she was. So, who are you? I've never seen you before, she asks in a quiet voice. Oh, I'm Death. I don't know how I got here, I explained. I was asleep at home and just woke up. I see. She nods as I finish wrapping the gauze around her shoulder. What about you? I question. I'm Meg Thomas. Well, Meg, nice to meet you. I was interrupted by the sound of a chainsaw. Spinning around, I saw a deformed man running towards Meg and I, chainsaw ready. Quick, follow me. Meg grabs my hand and runs, bringing me along once again. We duck behind another rock and crouch in some tall grass as the man runs past us before stopping to look around. Upon not seeing us, he lets out an angered yell and runs off. Are you okay? Meg whispers to me. Yeah, I think so, I nod, shaken. What was that thing? That was the hillbilly. He's one of the many killers out to get us. There's more of them? I look around quickly, backing up against the rock. No, only the hillbilly right now. She was about to continue explaining, but was cut short by a loud ding off in the distance. We look in that direction to see lights. Looks like Dwight and Jake finished the generator, Meg smiles. Generators? I look at her, confused. Yeah, there's a bunch of broken generators all over the place. We have to fix five of them to open these two big exit gates and survive. She continues on, explaining the trials. I nod, taking in all of the information. Follow me, the degenerate over there. Here, sorry. Meg walks around some trees and over to a small cottage. I follow her up the stairs and onto the balcony. Lo and behold, a generator is on the balcony. So, how do I fix this? I look at Meg. Well, there's a few knobs and wires they need to mess with. Also parts they need to switch, she explains. Though, Jake knows more than I do. That's the basic gist of it though. I nod and we start working on the generator. After a minute or so of turning knobs and moving wires, Meg and I hear a scream in the distance. That sounds like Dwight. I better go help him. Meg stands and walks to the edge of the balcony. Stay here. I nod and she jumps off the balcony, running in the direction of the screams. I continue working on the generator, the hydraulics on the top, moving quickly, signaling that I've almost finished fixing the generator. My heart starts beating rapidly, and I hear the low hum of a chainsaw from underneath me. I move faster, finishing the generator as it lights up in a loud ding sound. I quickly jump off the balcony and duck behind some trees as I hear the chainsaw rev and the hillbilly runs past me. I sigh in relief and move back towards the house to see what's inside of it. And that was chapter 1 of The Entity's Realm. So far, this is starting out to be kind of a good story. Let me know down in the comments if I should keep reading this or not, because I'll gladly do so. There's like 25 of these chapters, by the way. So, yeah. We got to enjoy this reading, and I will see you all next time. Peace.